want to play some Dell Claw, you know? Ain't nothing wrong with that, right? Testing out the volumes and stuff. I don't know if any of you people ever heard of Dell Claw. She's from L.A. I mean, I heard of Dell Claw from Rat Talk. And I don't know, I just came home, decided to play some Dell Claw, you know? You know, try to, you know, see, give a little something different, you know? Try a little something different with the page, you know, here and there, you know? Yes, come home, play some tunes for y'all people. Because I know we do the Vault Show. Which probably the Vault Show might be going back to Thursdays or something like that. You know, I don't know. Because I do enjoy interviewing the bands on the weekends. So, but I do love the radio show also. But, you know, I might have to do the radio show separate. Yeah, let's get back to some Dell Claw here, bro. You can dress and act however you decide to. You control you. Deny Dell Claw, bro. What's going on out there? I said we got one viewer up there, man. How's your day going? Who's this viewer right here? How's your day going, bro? What's going on, man? How you doing today? You're live here with D-Rotten. D-Rotten after hours. After hours meaning after work. You know? Play something else for your characters here, man. You know? Some stuff I normally don't play, man. You know? Let's see here, man. Take it old school. Let me take it old school here. I don't know how old school I want to go. You know what, man? This is one, bro. I hope the guy doesn't really get mad that I'm playing it. You know, but this is a really fucking cool. This was a fucking cool band when it was out. This is a band called Jar. And they had a song called Waiting for Heaven. And they were fucking great, bro. You know, the lead vocalist from Evil Atom was doing vocals for this one. I never played this live before, man, but, you know, yeah. It's on SoundCloud if you guys want to, you know, catch it anywhere else. But, yeah, I'm going to play it right now for y'all, man. After that one person listening, bro, this goes out to you, bro. It's called Waiting for Heaven, man. This is Jar, brother, and this is badass.
Everyone. of existence. Wipe with faith in things that never will come true. When you're on your deathbed, you'll regret the things that you never got to do.
So wish I could have fucking saw that band do live, man. They fucking killed it. I saw the video back in the day. I saw the video of one song from the Elks Lodge. I think they played the Elks Lodge, and they played somewhere else in New Jersey. Or it might have been Manhattan. I know it was two shows. And from the two fucking videos I saw, which is basically, I know one of them was a Halloween show. And I remember Renee was dressed up as like a killer clown or something like that. But it was pretty fucking dope. And I wish I would have went to those fucking shows. You know, it's another great band, bro. Another great local band, bro, that I fucking missed out on. But let me see. I got something else. Let me see if we got something else here for you. You know, let's. Who we got here? You know what, man? Let me rock this dude right here. I don't know if any of you guys ever fucking, if you guys are into the local scene over here in the late 90s, early 2000s. Well, late 90s, you know, mid to late 90s. You know, there was a guy out there, you know, called Craig Marshall. And he was fucking actually ripping out the fucking scene with bands like Witch Moon, Me vs. Machine. You know, he had fucking, he had two punk bands. I remember that. Before the industrial, he was in two punk bands. He was in Bastard Brigade, you know, but, let me play a little fucking, unreleased demo thing of his, man. Let me see what we got here. This one's pretty fucking good. This one to me is like, it's not fucking over the top guitars, drums and everything, man. But I mean, it's a really fucking feel good fucking song to me. You know, let me see if you guys actually agree with me here. If you don't agree with me, write it down, bro. Let me hear this shit, man. You know, this is After Hours with D Rotten, After Work Hours. This song's called The Great Experiment, man. dope. Was, you know, you just fucking, yo, there's a show tonight, I have to jump in the fucking car and that's it. You didn't fucking ask where, you didn't ask anything else, you jumped in the car, you made sure, you know, you got fucking high and drunk or whatever, you know, had a nice little buzz, you know, you weren't too fucked up to fucking not know where the hell you fucking were, you know, and you just fucking, you just go with the flow, bro, you just go. Man, that was the fucking days. Fucking, they said in all of it. Those were the days. Now I know what that motherfucking meant. You know, I mean, the days are still good, man. I can't complain, man. I have a fucking cool life, man. I have a great life. I have great friends, bro, still, to this day. But, I mean, those times were fucking so magical and so special, bro. It's like going to different shows with all your friends and stuff, man. Fucking, I'm getting all choked up. Nah, it was amazing, bro. And I know you guys fucking probably know the same fucking exact feeling as I'm just fucking talking about how, you know, you got those fucking special fucking shows when you were younger. You got those fucking moments and shit, man. You know? Let me get another one for you here, man. You know what, man? I'm gonna play you one of my fucking songs. How about that? I'll play you one of my songs that I've written. And this one is called Broken Record. I know that's a very cliche fucking name there. Everybody's used it and shit, man. But I don't fucking care. You know? I mean, to me, basically, the song is basically like, fuck, it's a broken record. So, you know, here we go, man. I'm going to play you one of my tracks. I really don't like playing my music because I hate hearing myself. I hate fucking, you know, hearing how I fucking sing and all that shit. But, man, let me stop talking and start rocking this, man. It's very gothic. Very gothic indeed. When I recorded this. Zip disc player, had a condenser mic, had a keyboard. And that was it, man. Just sat there fucking. That was actually a three-parter. It was, let me see. It was actually, kind of a four-parter, bro. It was Sleepless Hours, Poison Dreams, In Your Eyes, and Broken Record. It was like a four-parter kind of thing, you know. It was like the last fucking love jam I wrote or whatever, you know, like, oh, my heart is all broken, ah, you know, shit like that, man. But yeah, everybody does that when they're young, man. You let all that shit out, man. When you get older, you laugh at it, you're like, I wrote some cool fucking jams, you know. I mean, what are you gonna do? Hey, you can't change the fucking past, you know. Not everybody can, you know, be like the Flash, you know. I'm gonna do a Flashpoint, you know. Well, let me see here, man. Let me play another jam for you, folks out there. You know what, man? I'm going to play this fucking band right here, bro. This is a motherfucking band right here, man. I like them. I like them a lot. They're from Newark, New Jersey. And they were fucking pretty big time, bro, when I was coming up in the mid-90s, man. They had their own little scene going out there, you know, Point for Hope and shit. They had their own scene, and it was a great scene, bro. I used to go over, I went to a bunch of their shows with fucking Ruptured, you know, with Marcos, Lewis, Josh, Alex, and Armando, you know, like the little fucking crew going to Newark and shit, you know, and yeah, just fucking going there and having a good fucking time, man, you know, just going there to see some fucking bands and shit, man. You know, I'm fucking rambling. You know, I always play fucking Legalize and shit and all that, man. I'm going to play fucking Fast Food Culture, bro. This fucking band was... They were gods in Newark, man. I swear to God, you would walk up and down Ferry Street during the feast and shit, and you would see fucking these guys. And they were fucking gods, bro. The drummer in the band actually became the percussionist for El Nino later on. Hilarious, and the guitar player was one of the first guitar players for El Nino too. But that's another story. It's Fast Food Culture for you people, man. From Point for Hope, man. Fucking dope. This is crazy. This is my motherfuckers and Maxwell's, man. It was crazy. I'll tell you that story after. Fucking gray on vocals. Fucking Point for Hope, bro. That brings back so many fucking memories, man. It was them. It was fucking... I remember, okay, let me talk about that Maxwell show. At that Maxwell show, man, it was fucking Point for Hope, Third Degree, Ruptured Face, and fuck, man, it was Point for Hope, Third Degree, Ruptured Face, Maybe one more fucking band. I'm not too sure, bro. That's going way back. But that show was fucking killer, man. That was the night they introduced their guitar player, who actually was the guitar player from El Nino. Forgot his name. His name's slipping my mind right now, man. But fucking yeah, that show was fucking kind of Third Degree. Jesus Christ, fucking Sean Egan from Suffer. And he had Super Dave on bass. He had Crow on fucking vocals. And it was fucking, oh God, he had this fucking guy on drums, man, from Brooklyn. This dude was the first time I ever saw anybody use fucking triggers and shit, man. He was like, like all over the place. Like, and then also making fucking sounds and shit and triggered sounds and stuff. Holy shit, man. This guy was like so out of the box. Out of the motherfucking box, bro. You know, I'm gonna go get something to drink right here, man. If I'm gonna play a jam right here. If my boy's still watching here, man, I'm gonna play a jam for him right here, man. Let me see here. Hopefully it doesn't skip because, you know, the CD was, you know, not that great, but this one's for you, bro. I'll be right back. Gray from Point for Hope up in this motherfucker. Yo, man, that's fucking Face, dude. Face, yo, they were like, they were actually, I mean, I, you know, I mean, I can't. You know, it's been fucking years. But they were like number two band in fucking Newark. It was fucking Point for Hope. And it was fucking... Excuse me. And it was Face. Face was like that hardcore fucking punk, you know, fucking band and shit. Everybody was like, oh, Point for Hope sounds like, you know, Rage Against the Machine. Why? Just because the guy had the fucking braids and shit. The music sounded nothing like Rage Against the Machine. You know, I know Face to me, Face sounded like Madball. You know, that's just my opinion. They sounded like Madball, but they were fucking dope. You know, I remember fucking seeing him at the Portuguese Feast. I was with fucking Lewis from when he was playing with Mudrust. And I was fucking, they came out, the singer came out with a fucking fireman's hat on. Everybody was like, woo! You know, fucking noise blazing up and shit, bro. I was fucking high as mother. I was high as hell. I was blazing over in the corner with fucking, I won't incriminate anybody, but I was blazing, you know who the fuck you are, bro. I was blazing with, you know, we were... And we were blazing more than hip-hop and R&B that night. Blazing more than Hot 97 ever did, you know, after that fucking show. But it was fucking dope, man. That was the night where actually when Mudrust fucking played. And they tore the fucking house down, bro. They tore that fucking joint up. You know, I'll play you some Mudrust right here. Nah, you know. Let me get you a little Mudrust right here, man. I'll give you a little taste here, man. A little taste here. You know, let me see if I got it on here. A little taste of Mudrust. Yeah, let me see. I'll pick a quickie for you guys out here. Oh, you know, you people out there gonna love this one. This one's Swine. Yeah, I know what this one's about. Oh, you do. Oink, oink, oink. Their EP with Armando from Ruptured down in Floating Studios. Man, that shit was fucking... That was a dope time, bro. Mudrust was the shit, man. I remember they played fucking... They played the Elks Club a couple times, man, you know? And they rocked the fucking joint, man. They rocked the joint out, you know? Can't sleep on Mudrust, man. They were actually fucking... Played the fucking place with a lot of fucking reputable New Jersey upper northern East Coast bands. I'll just keep it that way. You know, they play with a lot of cool East Coast bands. But, yeah, man, so How's your day out there, people? How's everybody going? How's everybody doing, man? Chilling, killing, eating penicillin? How's everything going out there? It's quiet as a fucking church mouse on this fucking thing. You know? Get a little sippy to water. Oh. I'll play one more jam for you guys and I'm going to be out of here, bro. I think I tested this a little bit enough, you know, and tested it up a bit. You know, got the levels a little bit set, you know. I'll test it on some. Let me see here. What would be my goodbye? This is my goodbye. Next.
Sean.
The only other band that I know of that ever fucking did a fucking badass ending like that, it made you want to just kick somebody's fucking ass, is Pantera. That's on the level of Pantera to me. But have a good night, folks. Glad you joined me on D-Rotten's After Hours, After Work. I think, you know, well, maybe make this a Facebook thing. Who knows, man? But, you know, it's D-Rotten's After Hours, After Work. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, man. But, yeah, man. Got a lot of other new tunes I'd like to fucking play for you guys, man. You know, I don't know if we'll keep the vault going. Or, you know, just do every Sunday. We'll just interview bands. And on the weekdays, I'll do the after hours music stuff for you guys. Maybe I'll find a partner. If my Johnny Vapes can't do it, you know, I might find another partner for the radio show. You know what I'm saying? And fucking rock it from there, man, you know? Well, have a good night, everybody. I will see you again next week. Because I don't want to keep doing this for every fucking day, because then you guys are going to get bored of it. So I'll see you guys next week with this. Same bat time, same bat channel. You know, it'll be the, yeah. This is D-Rotten's After Hours. Peace.